Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. This week on the Boxford Lathe, I've decided to do something that I've been thinking about doing for 20 years, and that's alter the lamp. As you get older, your eyesight's not as good as it was when you're young, and you need a bit more light to see what's going on. It's finally got to me, so in today's video, I'll be showing how I move the lamp and why. So let's have a look.
It's 26 degrees in the workshop.
Today, I'm looking at doing some modifications to the lathe. One of them being a problem with the lamp. Ever since I've had the lathe, the lamp has been fitted on this tin plate at the back. But the problem with that is you lose one of your axes of movement, in that this is sticking out that way. You can only go up and down. You can't swivel the lamp round like you'd normally be able to do if the lamp was on a flat surface. So what I'm thinking of doing is putting some angle aluminium on here so that the lamp can stand upright, so that I can pivot the lamp round. Plate's only held on by some screws into the back. I've taken two out, so I'll just take the last one out and then fold the lamp down out of the way. You can pull the lamp out,
and it has a connector block at the bottom.
So if I undo the two wires, I think this is a remnant of when they used to have the motor on the back of the lathe and it fed through the side, pulley, the belt thread through the side here. But this one, the motor is in the base of the unit. So I'm going to spray with some grease remover. And I've just undone the four screws. Taking out the wire. So there's nothing technically on that, it's just a steel cover, sheet steel. It looks like most of the oil on the back here is off the headstock. You can see if I can fix this lamp so that the base is facing upwards, that'll give me another axis. See, that turns on that. I've got a piece of aluminium angle, but because this swivel mount needs to clear the back of the plate, I've had to extend it out onto this. This is a piece of the CNC bedding that I had left over. So I've basically used the same holes in the back plate here to hold the aluminium angle. Pop riveted this piece to it and then bolted it back on through the top. And the wire goes in the slot at the back down to the connection point. Right, I've just cleaned up the back of the machine. Just point out that what we've got down here, the connections for the lamp, just on a connector block. This piece here, this metal here, is just the shield, and it's welded to the base. It stops, if you're using suds, it stops the suds going down the belt hole here.
And then this at the back is a micro switch which cuts off the power when you open the door for the gear change.
So before, the lamp just stayed like that. All I could do is move it up and down and twist the top. But now I've got the ability to move the lamp over the chuck so I can get closer to the work when I need to. Or if I'm doing a bore, I can see easier. The original low volt unit, which has a 12 volt AC transformer. So it's important, if you're using the same transformer as the original, that you have an LED bulb that will work on AC. And this is the sort of light I get. It's a yellowy light, and it's okay. It's not brilliant. So what I've done is I've had a look on internet, and I found this bulb in the lamp is a Edison screw 27. I found this adapter, which is the same as the bulb, but with a, I think it's a just 2-pin holder in, and this LED lamp, which fits into that. And the only problem I've got is, if you move it a lot, the bulb falls out. So what I thought I might be able to do is put some double-sided sticky tape on there, just to hold it there. But let me show you the difference in the light. So that's a 12 volt LED bulb. And the light is brighter, and it's a white light rather than the yellow light, and it will use less power.
Thanks for watching. I hope it's been useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.